Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling as though you and I should take a walk down Browser Basic Boulevard and have a chat about how our browsers work. You know, browsers out of the box are just awesome tools. I'm talking Chrome, Firefox, Safari. They're windows to the internet world, and they give us access to so much information, but we can extend the functionality of those browsers using things called extensions. So I want to make sure that you understand how to manage, how to add, and how to control the extensions in your browsers. So it's Browser Basics today on Dotto Tech. Regardless of which web browser you use, they all can extend their functionality through something called extensions. Now, I'm going to take you on a bit of a whirlwind tour today through Chrome, Safari, and Firefox and show you how we can load extensions and manage extensions in each of those browsers because they all handle them slightly differently. That's why we have to go into all three. It'd be great if I could just show you one, but I can't. Now, what is a browser extension? Well, out of the box, our web browser allows us to access pages and to interact with web pages and websites. Extensions do things beyond that scope. For example, here, if we take a look in my install here of the Chrome browser, along the top here, you see a series of extensions that add functionality to my browser. And these are all tools that I decide that I want and that I use pretty much every day. So right here we have LastPass, which allows me to manage all of my different passwords to get into different accounts like my bank account and have secure passwords for that. The one that I probably use the most is the EverNote Web Clipper. And if you follow this channel at all, you know that I'm a huge fan of EverNote. What the EverNote Web Clipper does is it creates a link between EverNote and my web browser, allowing me to copy information that I find in the web browser directly to EverNote. It's basically a conduit between my web browser and EverNote. So this is a prime example of what a browser extension can do for you. I could accomplish the same thing by copying and pasting and then opening EverNote and then going in and pasting a note in EverNote and creating a new note. But now it's all done for me with one click of the mouse using the browser extension. That's where we really benefit from using these extensions. Now, how do you access browser extensions and how do you add browser extensions to your web browser? Let us begin there. Like most of the different features in on the computer now, there's multiple ways to get to the same place. But the easiest way probably is just going under the window menu in Chrome and choosing extensions. This will launch an area of the browser that allows you to manage all of the extensions that are installed in the browser. Now you can install extensions, but they don't always have to be active. So this is great if you have to use some extensions just for project work that you're working on and you want them turned on or off, or like me where I'm testing out different extensions and then preparing them for doing demonstrations. So you can see here that I've got a lot of extensions installed in my browser, probably more than I need, definitely more than I need. But as you can see, some of them are enabled and some of them are not enabled. And you can delete them at any time just by clicking on the trash can, which will delete them. So I've got all of these different browsers. Why do I not uninstall them? Because occasionally I'm doing different demos and I need to jump in. People ask me questions and most of the ones that are left installed are ones that I've done demos on in the past and maybe not necessarily using all the time myself. Having said that, how do we first of all add new extensions to our browser? Well, you can do that in Google Chrome by going to the very bottom of the extension page and saying get more extensions. When I click on get more extensions, it launches the Chrome store, which can be a little bit confusing because not only does the Chrome store, when we do a search, show us extensions, but it also shows us apps that can run on our smartphone and other things. Having said that, let's say that you were deciding to install the EverNote Web Clipper in Chrome, just like I have it. You go to the store here and you type in EverNote in the search. And up comes, once I do that search, up comes the different apps. As I mentioned, it does get a little bit confusing. There's some Android apps. But here, look for extensions. We can install, if I didn't have it installed, you can install the new extension that you need. You just click on Add to Chrome, and it does it very quickly and effortlessly. It just basically does a quick install, and then it will appear here in the menu bar of your browser. It's that easy to install new extensions into your browser. If we go back into the browser, if you want to enable or disable them, you can use the checkbox from here. And, there's an interesting one here. This is Dashlane. This is a digital, this is another password manager that I've used. And it's giving me a warning here saying that it was not installed from the Chrome Web Store. This is because I installed it directly from the Dashlane app when I installed the app. Sometimes apps, applications that you run on your computer will also create a web or a browser extension if you choose to enable that as you install it. But that could also be a warning is that something might have been installed that you didn't want to have installed. We've all had that happen, by the way. If you think about what happens when you say have, if you in the past, if you've downloaded a file and all of a sudden your browser acts differently, maybe it searches at a different home page, or there's all of a sudden little shopping tools all installed as extensions. That's often the case where something has been installed and you haven't given it permission. That's one of the reasons that you need to know about the extensions to be able to go in and discover those things that have been installed and turn them on or off. That's happened to us all. Every time you try and have some fun on the internet and download something new or play with some toy that probably, you know, that is not necessarily business related, you often end up with somebody modifying your browser in some way. But you can switch it back and you can take control by understanding the extensions. So that's how the extensions work in Chrome. Let's take a look and let's jump over into, in this case here, Safari. This is for the Mac users. In a moment, I'll show you Firefox if you are a Firefox user. Now, Safari manages the extensions, again, slightly differently. Here we go under the Apple menu, the Safari menu, and you can click on Safari extensions. Now, there's actually, again, two places that you need to know about within Safari to manage your extensions. When you click on Safari extensions, it actually launches the Apple website and allows you to install different extensions and search for the extensions from the website here. So you can see as we scroll down, we'll see that I have, the LastPass is installed on my browser. You can see that it's installed. But next to it is this improved Facebook and this widgets bar. And if I wanted to install any of those, I can click on install now. And you can read the descriptions, of course, of what the different extensions will do as you go through it. Some of them are really useful, some of them are really useless, but there's just a huge collection of them, and you can search for more. So let's do the same thing. Let's search for Evernote. And it's brought up the Evernote web clipper so that if it wasn't installed, I could install it again. So you do all of this from a web page in the Apple site. Now, if you want to manage your extensions, you go to a different place. You go under the Safari menu into preferences. And there you can manage, and you can see, I use Safari a lot less than I use Chrome, so I have a lot less extensions installed myself. I only have LastPass and the Evernote Web Clipper, but you can turn on and off the extensions here, enable them, disable them, just as we've done within Chrome. So you have the exact same control here in Safari. Finally, let us have a look at the same thing in Firefox. Here I am in Firefox. And in Firefox, they don't call them extensions, they call them add-ons. And we go under the Tools menu into the add-ons, and here we actually have access to not only add-ons, but the extensions appearance. And I misspoke. They do call extensions, but you get to it through the add-on menu, which is where you're basically adding anything into the Firefox browser. But again, you can see we have the exact same tool, the exact same potential for managing everything. And if we want to add more, we just go back to the Get Add-ons, and here we can search for the same, using the same search criteria, and I can see the available add-ons, and it tells me that in this case here, I can install the Evernote Web Clipper and these other tools that are all related to Evernote in one form or another. So we have the ability to, again, install right from this menu here itself. So regardless of which browser you're working in, the extensions work pretty much the exact same way. They extend the functionality. You need to know what extensions are running in your browser, which ones you use, and turn off the ones that you don't use, even if they don't seem to be bothering you, because they do use up system resources, so your computer will run faster if you have less of these installed. But have a look, because some of them are incredibly useful. I hope that you found this video today to be incredibly useful as well. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First is please subscribe to this channel. Second is if you subscribe to our newsletter, you will learn about all of our upcoming courses and webinars. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We are supported through the largesse of our patrons at Patreon. I encourage you to drop by the Patreon page, have a look, and discover the perks involved in supporting Dotto Tech. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.